I got a feeling called the blues. Oh Lord, since my baby said goodbye.
Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen, we are back with another John Lennon reaction. This time I'm going to be hearing God. This is probably going to be the last John Lennon song I do without listening to like an album or anything, because I've gotten a lot of requests to just do the whole Plastic Ono Band album. And I do prefer listening to music through an album, because I think you get way more from doing that. But I've gotten all these individual requests, so I do want to do this one, God. You know, you don't need to hear from me, John, in every song I've heard so far. Very poetic, message-based, kind of addressing society in some type of way, or just the world. And I've pretty much agreed with him on everything. And, you know, some would say he's stating the obvious, but he does it in such a musical, relatable way that it doesn't come off, you know, pretentious or annoying. It's just very nice to listen to. And I always seem to enjoy the message. So let's see what he says about God, or if God means something to him. I have heard the song Imagine, because I think that's like a song everyone in the world has heard, basically. But I do remember in that him saying, imagine no heaven, something, blah, 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 easy if you try. So I don't know if he's going to keep that mindset, but let's see. Nice slow song again. Say it again. God is a concept by which we measure our pain. Yeah. Yeah. Mm. Don't believe magic. Wow. I'm gonna pause right here. I would not be surprised if this was taken as a very controversial song, especially at the time. I don't want to get too much into my stance, but I think where I am with religion, and I know this isn't just about religion, but you know, it's called God. I kind of go back and forth between, is there a God? And I think I've always been kind of in this stance where I want to believe there is, but sometimes I can't convince myself. And so I'm just always kind of open to it. I think that's called agnostic. I don't know. I wouldn't like identify myself as an atheist. Like I celebrate Christmas. So I don't know, but that's kind of where I stand. As for the song, very kind of slow melodic, and then it picks up a little bit with a kind of a minor chord, which I really liked. And now he's saying all these things he doesn't believe in. He doesn't believe in Hitler, which most people would be like, good. But then he doesn't believe in Jesus, which a lot of people would be like, hey, hold on. I think he's kind of lumping it all into one thing, though. Not to say that Hitler and Jesus are the same, but that he's just saying he doesn't believe in either, you know? But let's listen more to see what he means. Mantra, I think he said. I don't believe in guitar. I don't believe in yoga. Yoga? I don't believe in kings. I don't believe in Elvis. I don't believe in Zimmerman. Just believe in me. Ah. That makes sense. I just pulled up the lyrics real quick. I want to kind of go through everything he referenced because I didn't catch all of it on first listen. But I definitely started to feel as he kept listing off these things he didn't believe in, you know. What do you believe in, John? You know, I was kind of waiting for that big moment. And then he says, I believe in me, Yoko and me. That's reality. And then he keeps repeating this, the dream is over and you have to carry on. I think in a lot of ways, no matter what you do kind of believe in, this is pretty brilliant, just the way it's kind of laid out. And the very start of the song too, with God is a concept by which we measure our pain. I also thought when he said, I don't believe in mantra, I don't know if that's the Indian thing that George believed in. It might be, but I was thinking, oh, is that a shot at George? But it's really not, because he's basically saying he doesn't believe in any of those things. He's set in reality. Him and Yoko are what matters to him, basically. And yeah, no matter how you approach life, I feel like that's something I respect. I let people live their lives. I live my life. And the dream is over. I'm not sure how to interpret that. Maybe he's just saying all these things are fake. But then, you know, you could make the argument, of course, that religion and God and all that's not real. But, you know, then he says he doesn't believe in Beatles, Elvis, yoga. I mean, a lot of these things do physically exist or did exist. So I don't know why he's referring to those as kind of all part of this dream that's over. But I mean, I guess that's how he interprets it. It was in the past. Now it is him and Yoko. And he just says you have to carry on. Yeah. Musically, I really enjoyed it. I thought it was slow paced, which a lot of John songs are. And I got a comment saying I've only reacted to kind of slower, sad Lennon songs, which I do acknowledge he has a lot of bangers too that I should check out. But yeah, I am someone who likes kind of slow melodic vibes, and this delivered again, and I liked his voice on it. I don't know if it's one of my favorite Lennon tracks, but I do really appreciate the message, and I think that's something that we can all kind of get behind, even if you are a true believer in something or all these things that he listed. But yeah, thank you for the suggestion. This is a really interesting one.